In that picture at Madison Square Garden is the famous one that's in the April Ebony magazine, chronicling the Muhammad Ali Joe Frazier fighting the century. 5-0, Ronald Garrett is also in that picture.
He's in the background. Yes,
okay. 5-0, but fast forward, your pops is out of jail. 5-0 has got some beef with somebody down in the projects.
You talking about when Lenny Tyson was from Lenny Tyson and owe Lenny Tyson some money. So Lenny Tyson is running around all the projects everywhere shooting at Garrett 5-0. You know, that nigga got to pay me my money. I'm a killer. I'm Lenny Tyson. So now they shooting at Garrett like a motherfucker Garrett, a little black bad motherfucker Garrett. And whooped one motherfucker's ass and came and killed him. Ran off on the other two.
Because Garrett was known for fighting in Motel Mouth. They talking about black boys talking about beating up the police.
I started off with 5-0. Ronald Garrett. And like I said, he was the fool out of the whole group. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about knocking police out. No.
To be a motherfucker to fuck with 5-0. 5-0 was going down a nigga instantly. He downed that nigga instantly, Lenny sent. Lenny knew. So now they busy running around. I guess this must have went on for some months, maybe half a year. Everywhere 5-0 would go, them niggas be looking to shoot and kill him. I mean, they was in search of 5-0 everywhere at the school. 5-0, you understand? All you can hear. My father even told me, Eddie, you stay away from 5-0. He was trying to kill him, but you have to run up on him. Don't you pick 5-0 up, because he got them niggas trying to kill him. So this all I could hear. So one day, me and my father come in at Donna Jean's place. She's staying down off Mac and 75. We come into Donna Jean's place, and Donna Jean is on the phone saying, Eddie, you need to pay these motherfuckers off so they can stop all that motherfucking bullshit around here shooting at school. Somebody gonna be got hurt, and then they're gonna be getting, and they shooting at this nigga and can't get him. So she on the phone talking to whoever, and this is what Donna Jean is saying. So she said, Eddie, you need to go and get that man that motherfucking $5,000 so they can cut that shit out. So my father say, I wasn't aware about this shit. I was locked up. I was in motherfucking jail when all this shit went down. Okay? So now, come to find out, somehow, Lenny Tyson is on the phone. So she had my father the phone to talk to Lenny Tyson. All right? So Lenny is talking to Faye, fat man. I know. Glad you're out. Big fella. How you doing? You know, Lenny is talking nice.
Right.
You know, why don't you go and pay your man's debt so we can go and get this shit over. Now, this is basically Lenny Tyson begging my father to pay the debt so he ain't got to keep these niggas trying to kill Garrett, because this shit, they got to be more of a job than he thought it would be. You understand? So Lenny is telling him, man, why don't you go pay the debt for that nigga fat mess? Yeah, man, I take care of the debt. Where you at? I send the money. I don't know. So he paid Lenny off the money and got Black Garrett where he could run back and walk around the streets free without them niggas trying to kill him, you understand? That was a motherfucker, though. That nigga called said, look, fat man, you the man on this. Man, go and pay that little motherfucker money off. You know that little money ain't shit to you. You know, Lenny got to make you feel, nigga, you know big as you. Come on, what the fuck is $5,000?
What he said, all I got is what he talked about. All about is my reputation, is the boy.
Yeah, that's right. It's his reputation. He's a killer, and he got to uphold his reputation. You ain't just going to take his shit and we don't keep. That's what I do. And Garrett is fucking his rep up. So we can just say I got paid, and hey, we all clear.
There you go.
Ain't heard nothing else since then. Boy, that shit was so funny. Boy, I'm telling you, that was a hell of a day. That shit was a motherfucker.
Oh, that's a project drama there.
Oh, was it? It was everywhere trying to down
him. 5-0 beat up a couple of them guys they sent.
He downed him. I told you the first one of them niggas come up there talking they should get downed him. Told you they had to come in folds after that. One wasn't enough, shit. Three or four got to come after one come. Shit. Again, they had it so shit was so funny when it was, you know, towards the end it was getting Black Garrett. They shooting at him like a motherfucker, like a cartoon character. I mean, they shooting at him like a son of a bitch. He running trying to get the goddamn gun out. Gun falling down. He running like a little motherfucking ape, man. This shit was so funny. Them motherfuckers flying on Gan trying to get that motherfucking gun out, hit the corner and go. Shit, them motherfuckers never did get, you know, so they ended the beef like that.
Your old man pays
Lenny $5,000.
The bounty was took off of 5-0.
5-0 was free.
And 5-0 was free.
Free he was.
Wow.
Now he needs some work. As I went, see, I said, nigga, I need some work now. And the fat man gave some work. I swear to God, that's how it worked. So that is that free thing. I need some work. Shit, nah. Fat man again was not good to my father.
Yeah, because he go back to he the glory back to the beginning.
You know, so, you know, I mean, truly, 5-0 was that dear. Pay the debt off and get a nigga house to work. Man, go to work.
That's some loyalty.
Yeah, he was dear. 5-0 was dear.
Salute to Ronald 5-0 there.
Salute to 5-0. That's the original 5-0.
Yeah.
That's the original 5-0. The real 5-0. Ronald Garrett. Hawaii 5-0.
That's right.
Ronald Garrett to make it happen. I don't even fuck what you say. Ronald Garrett was a motherfucker, man.
He's a famed legend in this town.
Man. Was he? Shit.
The legend of 5-0.
Yeah. And like I say, when I started off with him, you understand, I stayed in jail, you understand, fighting the police with him. I mean, he used to knock him out 2 and 3 and 4 at a time. 5-0, he was a renegade. I used to pick up his money. Anywhere, you understand, never less than 50,000.
Cause that case, the second case in fact is with your dad, that second case in Pennsylvania where they yes, get followed with the 11th, yes, 11th yes, race to jail, yes, and 3 keys and the race was riding with
the whole world. Yeah. Ronald Garrett was in on the indictment.
Original.
I mean, he got indicted too.
Ronald Garrett was indicted. He went to jail one day. You didn't know that?
Yeah. Yeah, he went to jail with everybody.
Yeah, Ronald Garrett was one with 32. He was indicted.
Man. Yeah. Okay, so what about last one before we just got since we're here? So let's back it all the way back up. Your father's blew up, meets at my dad's house. Tells the crew, look, I'm out of the streak, end of the deal. I done did the math. I'm just going to be a wholesaler. Y'all can buy from me. Y'all can buy from anybody else. But y'all been hell of a workers for me. You know, it's chronicled in the book. He gives my father $10,000. Your father gives the whole crew. Gives my father 5-0, Charles Rudolph, Russell Clayton, gives them each $10,000, which equivalent is like giving out $100,000 today's money. Says, you guys, do what you want. You guys, maybe we all family, but I'm going a different direction with my business.
5-0, we set our own operation up. 5-0 had his crew, and I had my crew.
Him and 5-0 feuded. They started that price war thing and ran the price of stuff down to half a quarter for $20, and they was just...
Instantly, my business took off. 5-0's took off. Anywhere from $40,000 to $50,000 a day.
Rudolph was my man. He would drop off the big bags of quarters to me, big shopping bags full of quarters, and pick up the shopping bags full of money.
5-0 and Dolph decide, he tells that they're gonna be their own boss, and they start the war. You heard any conversations about this? Cause both of them did, and shout out to Charles Rudolph, who's still alive and still here. The Rudolph 5-0 beef.
See, Butch was working for 5-0. See, so Butch can tell you more about that shit. The only thing I can really tell you is when my father closed Hancock down, all them niggas got the business. So along with giving you $10,000, he gave you the work on credit to serve the customers and pull up somewhere else.
Yeah.
This is when it started. See, stop. Before Hancock was the premier dope spot in the city. Jamie Harris, police officer, well documented. People did not sell drugs off of corners. It was not done that way at that time. That was unheard of. That would come after Hancock got broke up because they was getting the customers for Hancock and trying to bring them over to the block that Butch and Ronald Garrett was on, and they started running to the goddamn car fighting who could get to him first to serve him. And that's how the shit really got started, because Ronald Garrett and Rudolph was fighting over who gonna serve the goddamn customer first. If he seen Garrett serve the first 3-4 cars pull up, then Garrett getting all the goddamn cars, Rudolph, hell no! And they got the same product.
$2 denomination, which was unheard of until this Bible.
Because they took it on the streets. That's when they took it to the $10 penny. That's where it started from. Because up until that point, it had been pennies. You know, it had been penny caps.
And that model lasted in the streets, well, shoot, all the way to today.
Yes. The pack still.
And those still don't know that that origin of that $10 pack
started from
Bible and Rudolph.
Well, see, that's the thing. Now everybody think they invented the wheel.